obviously, you know at this point, it's the first time ever in Final Four history to have 4-1 seeds in the final weekend, but is it a trend that's going to continue? Hey, how are you folks? Jason Horwitz alongside Pete Gillen, Joe Jones, and Steve Lapis. Glad to be with you on Destination San Antonio presented by Coors Light. And guys, three times in the last 4 years, when you include this championship game, because obviously there'll be a pair of ones on Monday night, there have been one seeds playing each other in the championship game, but it had been 99 the last time before that. Why, and is it a trend we're going to continue to see?
I think so, Jason. The ones are so powerful, they're so talented, I think we're going to see more number ones in the championship. I don't think we're going to see four or even three. I think a lot of close games, but I think we're going to see two ones in a title game because of the talent, the coaching, the pedigree of the league. So I think the cream usually rises to the top, and I think we're going to see that in the future a lot in the title game.
Would you agree with that, Joe?
Well, I think it's an interesting question, but I think there is so much parity in college basketball today that a lot of these guys that are such good players are leaving early for the draft. So I think it puts a lot of pressure on these power teams to reload. So I think we're going to see a change in college basketball.
Steve, how would you explain the way that it has all played out this year, where a lot of people said these were the four best teams going in? They're the four that we've seen here. But years past, people talk about four best teams, and you don't see even half of those.
I think it's gotten whittled down a little bit. We're at the point now where there's only a few teams that can win the title. Sure, there's teams that can win a first-round game. A Belmont almost beats a Duke. That could definitely happen. But I think when it comes to winning the title, there's only a few teams. And we said it from the beginning of the year. There were only five or six teams that were capable. I would include this four and Texas. And I thought Tennessee, but I wasn't right about that. But there were only a few teams that could win the title, and they're all here.
But we're only 2 years removed from not having a single one seed in the entire Final Four. Let alone having all four one seeds. So we've got the complete opposite spectrum. 2 years ago, you had an 11 with George Mason, not a single one seed. Now you've got all four one seeds. You think that it's going to be the opposite. You think you're going to see less one seeds in the Final Four and more variety.
Yeah, I think we're going to see variety, in the Final Four. But the championship game, I think there's only a couple of teams, as Steve said, that have that pedigree, that every year they've been battling and have the depth, the talent, the poise to win the championship. So I think we're going to see the one against the one in the final game, but I think we're going to have a real mix in the Final Four. And I don't think we're going to see four and even three because the parity Joe's talking about. But I think when you get to the title, to win five games, I think only a few teams, Steve and Joe and Jay, can win five games.
You know I had to represent for the mid-majors. You know that, right?
Yeah, straight out of the Ivy League. Folks, that's how we do things here on Destination San Antonio, presented by Coors Light, all the way throughout the championship game. And, of course, the Final Four begins Saturday, 6:07 p.m. Eastern, from the Alamo Dome with the championship game Monday night, of course, on that same floor. Take care, folks.